playing for a team as strong as Japan.
Chengdu before that. It's a nice start here from Jungi.
5-1.
Even players like Shrija Akula, who've managed to take the world by storm.
Yeah.
It's, you've got to time it so well because you can get the arc as well as you can with. This is a very, very.
The kind of quality that we're getting.
100%. I mean, it's just the prize money rating is here.
Yeah, absolutely massive, isn't it? Oh, that could be life-changing.
Nicely done.
Well, that world champion, silver medalist in mixed doubles in 2017.
Back to back to back, 2016, 17 and 18.
Very talented player, but so is Miyuki Hara in the doubles. Asian Games as well. Jungi Jing, as you said, she's the one they look up to.
They've got some new stars as well, like makes the difference.
Yeah.
In team events, of course.
Trailing by four here. All game points.
Nice spin there on the power. Players are expecting it cross table because it's harder to play the parallels.
So Jungi Jing wraps up.
See if she can continue here at this marquee event. I was so surprised that this is the first meet.
High-level table tennis this year.
Mm.
So perhaps no surprise at the start that we've had from Jungi Jing.
1-2.
Got to the quarters as well at the star contender Lanzhou. So new stars that have emerged to make life difficult for everyone.
Yeah, it makes it. It's puzzling, right? You've had a pretty decent 2023, and then. Especially if others have played, like, look at what Jungi Jing's done. And played 17 matches already this year.
Obviously, Hirano, Ito, Hayata,
Nagasaki,
Hanamoto, very, very strong. She is, and she's making it hard for Kahara to punch. If you play it into very divisive here with how she's testing the in and out footwork. Kahara's footwork.
The last 16 points have gone Jungi Jing's way.
She's switching her around so well. Nice lateral.
Yeah, real trouble here for Miyuki Kahara.
9-4.
She seems like.
You see right away, changing the down.
11-5, second game.
Well, blink and you'll miss it. She hasn't just looked in any. Jungi Jing. Better start.
Very, very difficult to get behind because of how it's moving.
1-2.
But it's been.
It's the only point of the match where she's had the lead. And she barely holds on to it.
The top edge. Knows prevention's better than cure. Should have tried to play it somewhere else, she'll feel. I mean, it's okay going into the backhand.
Miyuki Hirano, her compatriot, who. Really peaked. Like,
they probably won't be playing the Olympics in Paris. Brilliant play.
So, whether if you start them very early, what the ramifications of that
very,
might
very
be.
Impressive result.
Even Ito isn't probably going to be telling out what there is going on there. Lots of equipment stalls.
So much for the fans to enjoy. And four away from wrapping up this match.
Look at this.
Gone the way of Jungi Jing. Oh, what we would expect. By now from Kahara, so few and far between.
Just been a little bit one-dimensional.
9-8.
Wow.
Tube serves with lots of...
Oh, what a rally that is.
11-8.
But I think Zheng Yijing's going to come firing here. And Kahara has to extra reality check for Zheng Yijing, and that can be a very positive thing.
Yeah,
this she's going to try and finish the point as soon as she can, but not snatch. Smart placement there. Good receive again.
Yeah.
Yeah, better there from Kahara. It's funny.
Four.
This is why
each and every point very different.
Four, games.
It makes you think, is it even a thing?
That's better from Zheng Yijing.
That wasn't necessarily the right one.
5-0.
We're seeing
Kahara. She's got six of the last eight. We've gone to Kahara.
Oh!
Seven.
Zheng Yijing made it too obvious with the four motion.
7-8.
But she misses a shovel serve. Wow! Brilliant.
9-8.
Can she cash in?
She set up two. Oh, she's recovered. Not quite.
Nine,
but Zheng Yijing pulls it off.
Game and match to Cheng.